in Christ's name. Let us praise God, who is our certain hope in all life's various circumstances. In the face of death, believe the good news the scriptures proclaim. As a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort.
Great.
special day. We will have a lifetime of memories and faith stories to share. Would you join me in prayer? Gracious God, your steadfast love endures forever. Your faithfulness to all generations, trustworthy in all your words and gracious in all your deeds. Minister now to us in our grief. Speak to our hearts your words of comfort. Touch us into hope through the promises of Holy Scripture. Enfold us in the fellowship of all who share our sorrow. Fill us with the joy and peace that comes from above. In quietness and peace, we wait upon you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on the earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who have sinned against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Thank you.
Testament this morning is from the book of Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 31, verses 11 through 31. And the word of God says, "A capable wife can find. She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from far away. She rises while it is still night and provides food for her household and tasks for her servant girls. She considers a field and buys it. With the fruit of her hands, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her land does not go out at night. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hand to the needy. She is not afraid for her household when it snows, for all her household are clothed in crimson. She makes herself coverings. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known at the city gates, taking his seat among the elders of the land. She makes linen garments and sells them. She supplies the merchant with sashes. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy, her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share in the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the city gates." Our New Testament reading is from the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 7. "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away.' And the one who was seated on the throne said, 'See, I am making all things new.' Also he said, 'Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true.' Then he said to me, 'It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end.'" May the Lord add his blessing to the reading and the hearing of his holy word. Amen.
Don't rob me of a blessing. That was one of Gerri's greatest hits. Don't rob me of a blessing.
despite our varied church experiences,
and they were varied.
The Church of the Brethren, the Nazarene Church, the Methodist Church, the Pentecostal Church, the Christian Church Disciples of Christ, despite all of those different places where she experienced God, her belief in who Jesus was and her relationship with Jesus was unwavering, was constant. Even the making of a salad was a labor of love. afternoon, the veil between heaven and earth is very near. The kingdom is very near. Gerri and saints of every generation are gathered with us. We are not alone. Yes, we are gathered in shared grief, but also in shared hope. We are saddened by the loss of Gerri, but hopeful because we know God is not far away and the kingdom is coming. We've already seen it in Jerry's life, her example, and her relationship with Jesus Christ. Do not feel robbed of your blessing. Gerri has been and will always be one blessing this world will never. open to all who believe.
You do not have to be a member of the Christian Church Disciples of Christ to partake in this meal with us, and so we invite you with open arms, if you would like to participate in communion with us, to do so. We come to this bittersweet ritual today, filled with a bundle of emotions. While our gratitude for Gerri's life is plentiful, our spiritual pain may be suffocating. Our home is a little quieter. Luna the dog may be searching for her morning kisses. We may be longing for a trip to the beach or a walk through the garden. Whether it's true or not, we may very well feel robbed of a blessing. We come here looking for hope that we can find only in God. Through this meal, we connect the past and present together, knowing that generation after generation has come to this table in their joy and grief. May the Spirit bless us as we celebrate at the peaks of life and as we abide in the shadow of the valleys. May the Spirit bring us the peace that will permeate our grief-coated hearts, and may the Spirit use this time and space to remind us that we are never alone in our difficult spaces. On the night he was betrayed, our Lord and Savior gathered his friends around a table, much like Gerri. For a meal. He gave thanks to God for that meal and made an ordinary space extraordinary. He took a loaf of bread from the table and broke it. And he said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after the meal, he again gave thanks to God. He took a cup from the table, and he said, "This cup is overflowing with the promise that's in my blood, shed for each and every one of you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us partake of this holy meal together. Thank you.
every days. A woman beyond compare. She worked hard, cared for her family, was strength, beauty, and dignity. And today, as we go from this place, we arise up and call her blessed, for each of us have been blessed by this woman of noble character. Her reward is great, and I have no doubt she was raised at the city gates. Many have been great days, but Gerri has surpassed them all. Well done, good.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. In the stillness of this place, we turn to God, who is our beginning and our end. From dust we have been made, and to dust we return. With reverence, we gather to thank God for the gift of Gerri to us, and to commit her earthly body to the ground, with the confidence that neither life nor death can separate any of us from the love of God we know in Jesus Christ. God of heaven and earth, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of the saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through your Son Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We hold in grateful memory this one who is now separated from us by death. Though we cannot recall her to life, we can remember her and fix her memory within our hearts for as long as we shall live. We can celebrate the fullness of her life with all its strengths, goodness, and weakness, and rejoice in the ties that bind us one to another. In this spirit, listen to these words of Holy Scripture. Recall the uniqueness of this one whom we honor. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Having commended Gerri, our companion on life's journey, into the hands of God, we now commit her body to the ground, confident that the one who has made us shall not leave us in the dust, but in Christ give us the victory of eternal life. We look to the final day when, as the scriptures promise, God will wipe every tear from their eyes. There shall be an end to death, and to mourning, and crying, and pain, for the old order has passed away. God of all life, we thank you for the life we remember here today. We ask that you be with us in the days ahead, as sorrow and loneliness weave their shadows around us. Through the power of Christ's resurrection, restore our hope and give us strength to carry on with our lives. We pray that your grace and love will be an abiding presence in this time of need. Fill our spirits with the truth of life. Grant us your peace. Amen.